said, we don't need Nigeria. All these Nigerians are bad people. Just imagine, Wizkid, you are going to mention Davido. Are they from UK, Liberia, or South Africa or something, and they are treating you like this? Like, hello, hello, hello. Welcome to my channel once again, once again, once again, once again. Charlie, today I am here again, and I am coming to talk. I am here to talk, just to talk to you. And please, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please and please again, subscribe to my channel. Click on that like button, please. Click on that like button. And if you can, please share my video for me, because without you, all these things that I'm doing it in vain. So please and please again, subscribe to my channel, like the video, and do what? Share. What am I here to talk about today? You remember, if you are someone that you have been watching my videos for a very long time, you would remember that I did a video that it was actually an interview that I was doing. I was basically interviewing Nigerian business people in Ghana, and I remember, Charlie, people came at me, like, especially Ghanaians, so. They were like, why am I, like, have I been paid to even promote these Nigerian businesses in Ghana? And are they legal? And I was like, so can't I do that for a brother, like an African brother? I just don't understand why my own people, my own Ghanaians, like, when you go to this comment section, they were coming at me like something. I was like, so if you are there as a Ghanaian and you hear any person from any other country praising your country, then you are happy. If you are there and you see any other person from anywhere praising Ghana, you see Ghanaians coming and, like, they are happy and they are commenting, we thank you, this. But why is it that when a Ghanaian is trying to praise a Nigerian or promote a Nigerian or anyone from any other country, you people start coming at me? What, like, why? I always say Ghanaians, eh? I am a Ghanaian. So I will say some Ghanaians, we are too hypocrite. Seriously, we are too hypocrite. Some Ghanaians, we are too hypocrite. If you go on YouTube right now, the number of Nigerian YouTubers making videos to praise Ghana on certain, like, certain things that Ghana has and they don't have, especially when it comes to governance. I know Ghanaians, we are not even okay with the kind of like governance that we get in this country, but yet still, other people appreciate what we have, and they are praising us, and they are praising our president and all that. But we are here, and I am a Ghanaian trying to promote an African, a brother. Charlie, people came at me. Let me tell you, today's video is all about why I love Nigeria and why I love Nigerians. Why I love Nigeria and why I love Nigerians. Let me tell you, there are so many things that I love about Nigeria. That country and its people, let me tell you, I love them so much, because there is something that you people, perhaps some of you, are not seeing. But today I am here to break certain things down for you to know. A country like Nigeria, that its citizens always complain about bad governance, and we hear them. I have so many Nigerian friends, and they talk about it, and Charlie, when they are talking about that thing to you, they are explaining certain things and what goes on in Nigeria, eh? Listen, in Nigeria, most of the people don't have stable electricity. Most of the people don't have stable electricity, and even water, proper roads, is very difficult. Like, the government is not doing all these things for them. But yet still, they are still the leading movie industry, or they have one of the leading, they're actually the leading in Africa, and even sometimes in the world, A country that doesn't have electricity, nor proper water. But yet still, they lead in music, like the music industry. Because as an artist, you need to go to the studio to do music, to record. And imagine when you go to the studio, you are recording and there is light out. But yet still, these people are able to do this to the extent that an artist like Burna Boy has been able to win a Grammy. Do you think it's easy? Sometimes some Ghanaians, I sometimes ask myself, so is it that you are saying these things or you are giving this bad comment? Have you ever traveled outside before? And another thing that I sometimes it hurts me most is how some people, I think even in South Africa, in Kenya, and even in Ghana, some of these Africans, we treat Nigerians badly, and I just don't understand why. Why do we treat our own people, our own, like they are black, we are black, they are Africans, we are Africans. Why do we treat them like that? In Ghana, I've heard stories like a Nigerian can come from, let's say, Nigeria to even school in Ghana, and sometimes they will go to look for an apartment to rent, and the moment the landlord or the landlady will hear that this person is from Nigeria, they will not give that apartment to the person. Why should it be so? Let me tell you, these Nigerian guys that have, let's say, spoil the name of Nigeria. Imagine the population of Nigerians that we have, over 200 million. And let's say all these Nigerians are bad people. Just imagine, can we contain them in this world? Can we contain them in this world? Because over 200 million people, you understand? We should stop this thing that we do. Like, we should stop this thing that we do. It's not every Nigerian who is bad. Okay, you let me ask you a question. You are saying Nigerians are bad. I don't have any problem. But now, if I tell you to even mention 5 top artists in Africa that you love their music, definitely you are going to mention Burna Boy, you are going to mention Wizkid, you are going to mention Davido, you are going to mention Omalay or something. But the question is, these people that I mentioned their names, are they from UK? Where are they from? All these guys, Jim Ike, Ini Edo, Genevieve Inaji, all these superstars, you love them, you love to watch their movies, but why is it that when their people come to your country, you treat them like trash? Why? I remember some time ago I said we need Nigeria as Africans, we need Nigeria to be okay, everything in Nigeria to be okay, because Africa needs them. I made that comment and someone said we don't need Nigeria. Please, this mentality of you being a Ghanaian and perhaps for a very long time nothing bad has happened in this country, so you are safe, you are cool, you are free, you eat, you do everything. Imagine you are a Ghanaian and you travel outside this country to, let's say, Liberia or South Africa or something, and they are treating you like this, like the way you treat Nigerians in this country. Will you be happy? I don't know whether you understand that feeling of you being a foreigner in someone's country and they are not welcoming you but treating you like trash. Charlie Ghanaians, we should change this thing, this attitude. South Africans, Kenyans, Tanzanians, everybody in Africa, Charlie, we should change this attitude of ours. It's very, 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 very bad. It's very, 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 like, very bad. Imagine all this instability and the government not doing anything better for its citizens in Nigeria. Always Nigerians say that if they have even half of the kind of governance that we Ghanaians we have in this country, let me tell you, that country, Nigeria, can even compete with America. Because citizens, they are very hardworking. Let me tell you, they are very, very, very hardworking. The Nigerian citizens. Imagine they move from different countries, go to, like, from their country to a different country, and still they thrive. All because they know how to do what? Basically thrive and make it in life. So if they have all these social amenities, everything is okay for them in their country, do you think they will even travel outside? They will not. So all I want to say is, please don't treat them like that. It's actually a country that I really, really, really love and its people. Don't treat the country like that. Okay, so my next point is, you know, Nigerians, if you are someone that you mostly come on YouTube and you watch videos about on YouTube, you would realize that there are so many Nigerian YouTubers who talk about Ghana and who are praising Ghana. Let me tell you, these are people that are not even shy to praise another country when or if the country is doing something better. They are not shy to praise that country when the country, its people and its government is doing something better. You understand? These are the kind of people I'm talking about. Unlike my own people, Ghanaians, even if they know that the thing is not going on well in their own country, and you talk about it, Charlie, they will just come at you like something. Charlie, I know that you love your country. You don't want any foreigner to talk about your country badly. But sometimes when something better is going on in another man's country, just feel free and do what? Talk about it. It doesn't take anything away from you. My next point is, imagine Nigeria has this tag of being 419, scammers everywhere, Yahoo Yahoo boys and all these things. That's some Nigerians give the country that bad name. But yes, still, as I said in my first point, some of the citizens are actually doing something great outside, and they are still giving this country a good name. And I know you know what I'm talking about. I'm going to emphasize on this movie actors and actresses, and sometimes even some individuals, the amazing things that they are doing outside. Their b-ball team being able to win from here, from Africa, and entering into the NBA competition. Like, so many things happening, so many good things happening in that country. And some people are really, really, really giving Nigeria a very good name. And I really love that about these people, because Charlie, some people are giving the bad name, but some also are giving the country a very good name outside. This point that I want to give, this is my last point. And if you look at this point, I'm basically talking about the Nigerian government. I think this is something that the Nigerian government is doing right for its citizens. I don't know what Nigerians will say, but I feel in Ghana, I am a Ghanaian, so I have to say the truth. Things are very expensive in Ghana, I must say. Things are very, very, very expensive in Ghana. So it has actually given some Nigerians the advantage to import, buy stuff from their country and import it into Ghana and sell. And let me tell you, they make lots of profits. All because the prices that we sell certain stuff in Ghana, they don't sell those things the same price in Nigeria like that. So, for instance, a Nigerian will buy, let's say, an earpiece in Nigeria for the, let's say 400 naira or even 300 naira, converting that money into Ghana cedis is like four Ghana cedis or three Ghana cedis. You understand? But let me tell you, that four Ghana cedis and three Ghana, and that four Ghana cedis and three Ghana cedis, you can never get that amount or buy that earpiece at that particular price in Ghana. You understand? So that is what I'm trying to talk about. When it comes to electronic gadgets, I'm very sure it is very cheap there. So many like Nigerians that you see in Ghana doing businesses, most of them are into laptops, earpiece, phone accessories, phones, and all these things, because I feel it is cheap over there. So when they buy it and they import it into Ghana, they sell it and they get profits. You understand? And these are some of the things that I really, really love about Nigeria and Nigerians. So please, anytime that you are dealing with any Nigerian, please know that you, one day, you will also travel, or a brother of you or a sister of you will also travel. And that person can be treated the same way you are treating the Nigerian here. I thank you so much for watching this video. Please, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do so. Subscribe to my channel and like the video for me. Please subscribe to my channel and like the video. I thank you so much. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.